Hey guys, this is David Kwan. Recently, I came upon the Avril Lavigne song, Here's to Never Growing Up. You know, and it's an interesting song. I don't quite like the song at all, but it made me like realize something. You know, this is Avril Lavigne, and she's, what, like 28, 26 now, and she's making a song in which lyrics are like, you know, here's to never growing up, and it feels like a teenager is singing the song out of rebellion. And watching the music video, she still looks very similar to how she looked when she first debuted. It's amazing. And I don't know, I look back and I kind of grew up with Avril Lavigne. I was about 14 or 13 when I first heard of her. And I really liked Avril Lavigne back then. I still, like her first two albums, Complicated and Under My Skin, I've been listening to them. I just put in my Pandora channel as I made a station, Avril Lavigne station, and those songs came on. I'm just like, wow, I still actually really like these songs, and I still really like Avril Lavigne. No shame, I have no shame about it. She's one of those artists I love her attitude of just being her own free spirit, doing whatever the hell she wants to do, and just saying fuck you to everyone else who gives a damn about that. So really, it's amazing. I grew up with just her songs, at least the first two albums. I haven't really listened to her later albums. I do think like her music has kind of changed, but even her first album, which is Complicated, I believe, that album is just an incredible mix of like her potential. I think I really liked that album. I used to listen to that album so much as a junior high student and as a high school student. Listened to it so much. I think I drove one of my friends crazy just talking about like how much I liked Avril Lavigne in those days. Drove him nuts. But because it's a song where it kind of there's Complicated, which is kind of a poppy song, and there's Skater Boy, which is kind of poppy rockish song. And then I'm With You, which is kind of a ballad. And then there is, I think, it's, you know, I'm trying to remember back to the songs I listened to so much. Anything But Ordinary, I really like the spirit of that song because it really does reveal so much about Avril Lavigne's philosophy of just being wanting to be anything but ordinary, really just being herself and just doing whatever to possible to the most extreme degree and just enjoying life to the fullest. I always get that sense from at least just her two earlier albums, and this song, Here's to Never Growing Up, is just so ironic watching this because it's just like, wow, this still looks like the same Avril Lavigne I grew up listening to. She really doesn't look like she's changed all that much. Also, it's just weird because I'm probably the same way to a lot of other people. I'm 26 now. But that always surprises people. Like some of the people that I meet for the first time, they ask how old I am. I'm just like, I just turned 26. So I would actually say, you know, I'm 25. And they're like, wait, what? No way. I apparently look much younger than 25. So that's interesting. But I look back all the pictures of myself back through the ages. I still look the same as ever. Really, the 22-year-old version of me doesn't look too different from me right now. The 18-year-old version of me doesn't look too different. 16-year-old version of me doesn't look too different from how I look right now. Like the picture is side by side. So that's interesting. That's really crazy. Although with me, I'm not going to age well, knowing my dad. Because my dad looked really, really like he looked the same up till the time he got up to like 45 or 46-ish, around there, like early 40s or mid 40s, he started balding really badly. Like he is now like all this part, the front part of his head is just completely bald. And yeah, he looks really old now. He has not aged well. And my dad, one time he like looked up, like he lifted my hair up and was just like, I think you have the same type of hair as me, so it might be genetic. When I reach 40 or 45, I'm going to look like a really old guy. But until I hit 45, I'm going to look like this. I'm going to look super young the entire time. Anyway, I digressed. I wanted to talk about Avril Lavigne, really. And really, just her first album is amazing, because it's such a mix of different kinds of style. She even raps in that album. She has a rap song in there, kind of ish. It's still kind of pop-ish, but she does have some, like, you know, rhyming section. And yeah, I actually, you know, it feels weird to say this because, you know, as a guy and all, but I really do like Avril Lavigne. And I think Under My Skin was more of a serious album. And it does, that album has songs that are much sadder and more personal in tone. But I think that was a good progression from her. And I never really got the chance to delve into her later albums. But it's really interesting just listening to this song, Here's to Never Growing Up, with this ridiculous lyrics of shouting my, you know, yelling out to Radiohead, which is nonsensical because how Radiohead songs are meant for that. But that's Avril Lavigne. She has this unique personality. You know, she wears her attire of a tie, and it's it was always interesting to me. I think she was a personality that, a musician personality that I personally just kind of grew up. My musical taste is still kind of trapped in the past of like the late 90s and the early 2000s. I still listen a lot of times to that radio stations that I used to grow up listening to as a junior high school student, you know, stuff like. Avril Lavigne was one, Vertical Horizon, you know, when Creed was a big thing, way back in those days. It's pretty crazy. I did have a phase in during my high school years when I just had an obsession with songs in the 70s, you know, like Guns N' Roses, Motley Crue, and Led Zeppelin, I guess, is the 80s, like the early 80s or late 70s. Yeah, but really, like, it's Avril Lavigne and those kind of groups that really just I grew up with. So it's really interesting to consider how we grown up to this point. She's like, I don't know, 28. I'm like 26. We've always been like this 2 years apart, because I think her first album, Complicated, she did when she was 16. And she's grown up now and still singing about how she'll never grow up. Isn't that funny? And that's just what I wanted to share with you guys. Cheers.